Like five questions. Very young doctors, any experienced doctors? Yes, sir.
Do you think that this facility will be used one day?
Mic. Yes, sir.
Do you think those missiles you have made will be used one day in war?
One day?
In war. For war purpose. Those missiles you have made, they will be used for war purposes also or not?
I don't know, sir.
Missiles will be used for the war purpose.
I personally believe that for example, you look at the aircraft. You know, Wright brothers and others, they discovered the aircraft. The aircraft can carry passengers, jets, they carry passengers. And also aircraft can carry bombs and missiles it can carry. Similarly, a nuclear system, it can generate electricity. Nuclear power can set E equal to MC square, same equation, then generate the electricity. And also it can get cancer therapy, that is treatment, radiation treatment, and also it can make a bomb. So it's a civilian application, but the electricity can be used for many defense purposes also. But finally depends on a righteous humanity, a righteous man. That is a political system, they have to decide what is the righteous way of doing. He decide whether it's used for peaceful or it can be used for a war. Okay, sir? Agony was there when I failed also. That is, for example, first Survey 3, when I launched 1979, and instead of putting the satellite in the orbit, it went to Bay of Bengal. Okay, it was a failure, utter failure. But there I learned something. Of course, we found out why it has failed, and successfully we launched. But the next one. But on that day, something happened. That is, I had leader, that is chairman of the Indian Space Organization, Professor Satish Dhawan. There was a press conference in the morning. All the whole country's press and international press were waiting 1979 to know what happened to the flight, success or failure, because India's first launch vehicle. On that day, he took the responsibility, the chairman, I take the responsibility for the failure because I have to give more scientific input and more technological input, more managerial input. In another year we'll succeed, he said. Next year when he succeeded, he asked me to go and conduct the press conference. Do you follow? That means when the success came, he asked me to share the success, that is. Whereas failure came, he absorbed. That's the leadership. The great leader, he absorbed the failure, and when the success comes, he gives to the team members. Okay, sir? Good question. Yes. Which year? You are intern in the internship. What do you want to specialize? Gynecology. Good luck. Okay. You can give a mic, I say. Fast. Why not you move fast? Okay, shout.
To this profession, because in their formative years they have faced a lot of problems. Like a big problem that everybody focuses is that there are not many doctors that are available in the peripheries of the country to serve the people. But the reality is that there are many undergraduate students who fight for their who fight like anything in the studying in the libraries to clear the post graduation. There is the need of doctors, there are undergraduate students available, but still the postgraduate seats are so limited. Why is that so, sir?
See, I have a feeling. See, if you look at the demand pattern, I will say demand pattern from parents, okay, not children. Parents want their children to go to professional courses, that is medicine, management and engineering. Now, this is because they purchase, they get loan for education, and naturally they want their children to be prosperous, so they want to them their professional courses they have to take. Now, my analysis indicates, about 5 years back, there was shortage of engineers. Today, engineering institutions, so you become surplus, thousands of people is available. Similar situation, medical community also, medical management, number of institutions will increase. Then this type of the shortage will not be there. And also reservation problem will vanish. The number of seats will increase. And naturally, number of teachers also will increase. Number of good laboratories you have to increase. Research intensity should take place. I hope it's going to take place. Yes, sir. How do we graduate a human being? Well, sir, then how do we graduate human to a human being?
Yeah.
And shall I tell you how to do that? Shall I tell you that?
Absolutely, sir.
Yeah.
That is what I want.
Will you repeat, all of you? Will you repeat? You are hungry? No. Will you repeat what I am saying? Because you asked a good question. Sir, what are you doing?
He's a cancer surgeon, sir.
Cancer surgeon.
Yes.
Good question you asked. So, where, talk I say, where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the world. That means one of the very important quality what you need, the righteousness in the heart. Now, righteous in the heart, who will give? Who will give righteous in the heart? Father, mother in a spiritual environment, they can't neglect their responsibility. Father, mother in a spiritual environment and the great primary school teacher. These are the three people can give the righteousness in the heart. Probably that will help.
Thank you, sir.
Sir. Last question, yes. Yeah.
Sir, the topic of your today's speech was compassion in the
medicine and compassion.
Medicine and compassion. I just wish to inquire one question. When we talk about modern values, it becomes very abstract in the modern world. The modern world is so materialistic. Is there a separate line of materialistic values apart from human values, and do they contradict? And if they contradict the world that we see, please give your opinion about it. Thank you so much, sir.
See, I have a feeling the education with value system, it has to start, the two people can do education with value system. There is a one Greek philosopher, he said, you give me a child, 5 years child, leave to me for 7 years, no devil, no Satan can take away my child, because you are so sure his education is very good and moral side very good. So my feeling is I am promoting what is called evolution of a enlightened citizen. Evolution of an enlightened citizen, one of the important requirement, education with value system. The education with value system can be given at two parts, up to 17 to 20 years, the home, then father, mother. If they are a spiritual human being, they can impart the spiritual thoughts to their children. Okay? If you have got a good library, home library, fantastic book you have, you start reading, your children also start reading. What do you say? Yes or no? If you look at TV continuously, they also will see TV. Now you can't complain to your children. Okay? So then, of course, a great primary school teacher. Great primary school. These are the people can change our children. I am pushing that idea. Okay, sir? Wish you all the best. If you have any question, you can send me my mail apj@abdulkalam.com. apj@abdulkalam.com.
Thank you very much, sir. A big round of applause.